Endaweni ngendawo lapho sifinyela khona siyithimba le insimbi news le ndaba kaSifundo Andisonga kwaMchuna ke ngisho ukuthi siphekwe bakwethu zabantu aziyaphakwa manje sanibona inyuwane yabasebenzi neHowie Marshall emahhovisi omnyango wezokubusa ngokubambisana kanye lezindaba zobuholi bomdabu kwaZulu Natal eMgungundlovu enkabeni yedolobha ke lapho kade phambisa khona uhlulo lwezikhalazo zabo kumphathiso omnyango kuNomzana Sipho uAyanda Zulu ngunobhala weNehawu kwaZulu Natal ubalule ukuthi-ke kufanele abasebenzi beqashwe ngokugcwele asimcaphune.
UAyanda kwaZulu ngunobhala weNehawu eKZN. Namuhla sizoqala laphana kwa-Cocta Department. Sizo-hand over i-memorandum qala ku-MEC wakwa-Cocta, Honorable Mr. Hlomuka. Kunabasebenzi abayinqwaba lokhu baqala ukusebenza ngo-2010 abangekho permanent. Sifuna labo basebenzi bonke i-department ba-convecte bebe permanent. Ingxenye yokuqala-ke yemashi yethu leyo. Eyesibili uyokhumbula-ke msakazi ukuthi namuhla kuhleli i-constitutional court ngodaba lwabasebenzi ukuthi kuthe ngasekupheleni konyaka i-Labour Appeals Court yadeclara u-Resolution 1 of 2018 clause 3.3 unlawful. So namuhla-ke ama-unions aya-agreesha why they think that that collective agreement is constitutional. So we are here to support the proceedings in defense of collective bargaining, which we do think as the union is under attack. The first part we're definitely hoping that in a few days, 7 days from now, the MEC will call us to a meeting. And in the proceedings of the Constitutional Court, we're more optimistic that the Constitutional Court will rule in our favor on the basis that the right of collective bargaining is one of those rights that was our major achievement during 1994 breakthrough. So we are optimistic because we do think that the outcomes of the Labour Appeals Court had some flaws as far as the law is concerned.
Basic Education Department releases May June second chance matric examination results. The matric results for May June examination have been released today. This means all the candidates who participated in the exams are therefore called to go and collect their results where they wrote their examinations. A total of 239,024 candidates enrolled to write the examination. This includes both the National Senior Certificate and the Senior Certificate. The department's Terence Keller elaborates.
Terence Keller, Media Relations Officer, Department of Basic Education. The Department of Basic Education has today released the May-June second chance matric examination results. Now, what this means is that candidates that wrote the May-June examinations in 2021 are now eligible to collect their results. Now, candidates can collect their results at the center where they wrote or either their nearest district offices. But in the case of those that wrote the senior certificate, they can also log on to the department's website, which is education.gov.za. A message from the Department of Basic Education.
Ngodaba luthi kungqongqoshe wezempilo kwaZulu Natal uphika izinsolo ezithi-ke ube nendumezulu yephansi lapho-ke izihambeli-ke zalo mcimbi kubikwa ukuthi bezingayilandelanga-ke imigomo nemiqathango phela ye-COVID-19. Ungqongqoshe ngomlomo okhulumela umnyango wezempilo kulesifundazwe noMzana Ntokozo Maphisa uthi ungqongqosheke unkosikazi kunomagugu uSimelane Zulu wabizwa watshelwa ukuthi-ke uya emhlanganweni kanti ubebizelwa-ke umgubho wokubungaza kusuku lakhe lokuzalwa engezelele phela i-surprise birthday party. Lo mgubho-ke ububanjelwe endaweni yeyimfihlo lapho kade-ke uhanjelwa abangani-ke kanye nezihlobo. Efika endaweni yomgubho-ke uSimelane Zulu ube sebona ukuthi-ke eminye phela yemigomo-ke nemiqathango ye-COVID-19 ibingalandelwanga-ke njengokuqhelelana-ke nokuyilapho-ke yena uqobo eqondise lokhu. Kubikwa ukuthi-ke bezingamashumi amathathu kunesithupha izihambeli-ke ebezihambele unalo mcimbi. UNgqongqoshe uSimelane Zulu-ke ube segqugquzela-ke izihambeli zakho kuba-ke zihloniphe phela imigomo ye-COVID-19. Kanti okhulumela kumnyango kuNomzane uNtokozo Maphisa unaba kabanzi ngalolu daba.
KZN MEC for Health Nomagugu Smelane has noted allegations pertaining to a surprise birthday lunch which was held yesterday and wishes to state the facts as follows. The MEC accepted an invitation to a purported meeting which turned out to be a surprise lunch for her birthday. This lunch took place at a private venue and was organized and attended by close family and friends of the MEC. Upon her arrival, the MEC first expressed her surprise and noted that there was adequate social distancing and indeed people were wearing their mask. She then personally conducted a headcount of those who were in attendance, which showed that there were 36 people on site. She went on to encourage those in attendance to adhere to social distancing and constantly use the hand sanitizer that was freely available at the venue. There were two tables, which were main tables at the sizable and well-ventilated venue, with some of the attendees opting to be seated at the veranda. As people started eating, they had to take off their mask, and as they were eating, there was a time during a brief musical performance where the guests stood up and danced, unfortunately without wearing their mask as they were still in the process of eating. The MEC deeply regrets the failure by some of the attendees, including herself at that time, to wear masks during this short performance which took place as people were dining and eating. The MEC will be submitting a formal report to the Premier regarding this incident, and the MEC remains committed to fighting the spread of COVID-19 in KwaZulu-Natal.